Good, welcome everyone. Glad to see a lot of you over here. Today I'll be speaking on the topic of PSR7 and middleware. Just a short introduction about myself. My name is Zion. I'm a Zen certified engineer and currently I'm a tech lead overseeing a team across many different languages like iOS, Android, Java, Ruby, Node.js, and of course PHP. I've learned quite a few languages before, but my favorite all these years is still PHP, like what Michael said, right? It's the easiest from A to Z. If you want to find out more about me, you can visit my website at zion.sg. So now I'll go into the topic proper. Now, just a show of hands, as I point out the logo, if you have used this framework or CMS before, please raise up your hands. KPHP? Okay. Drupal? Okay. Laravel? Or even more. So this Magento, Symfony, E framework, and finally Zen framework. Okay, there's another person, very good. I thought there would be not none. So for those who put out your hands and know what PSR is, hands up. Okay. So now all these frameworks and CMSs, they support and they use PSR. So what is PSR? PSR is basically PHP Standards Recommendation. It was proposed by the PHP Framework Interoperability Group, FIG for short. Okay, that's a website. Now it was started by some framework developers. They met at this conference, PHP Tech Conference in 2009. So the thing, we are all going at different tangents. Why not we come together to see whether we have any common interests, anything that can work together and make our community great again. So now there's about 40 voting members from various projects like Composer, Pair, Magento, Drupal, and like the CMS you saw just now. Now these projects, they adopt the standards. Others are welcome to. You are welcome to, I am welcome to, but it's not compulsory. Hence the word recommendation. Okay, quite a favorite cartoon over here. Now, being easy to pick up, PHP sees many different kinds of developers and projects with different qualities, styles, design, implementation. This has led to some impressions that PHP is not good. Okay, but actually it powers about 81% of the world, of the websites in the world. Now, projects who join FIG as voting members do so because they want developers who use and contribute to their projects to be exposed to best practices and also to help shape the future. And also this helps to ensure the employability of PHP developers. Just a short list of what are the things that they recommended. PSR0, which is the auto-loading standard. So this one helps to ensure that we can use a component from Zen framework and use it in a Symfony framework project, because they have a common auto-loading standard. PSR1, basic coding standard. PSR2, coding style guide. Now, a coding style guide is when you have an open source project and you have 1,000 contributors coming from different nationalities, different programming backgrounds, different experiences, you will want them to sound type in the same way. So, okay, we use spaces, 4 spaces instead of tabs. They recommend the bases to be on the next line or on the same line and the new line after each code. PSR4, auto loading standard, which is an update to PSR0. And PSR7, there's a lot more. I think right now there's PSR to PSR20. Some are still in the voting process, some have already been confirmed. And according to Matthew Weofini, he is the project lead for Zen framework. He calls PSR7 the future of PHP. And I'm going to touch on 2 parts later. The first part is going to be talking about PSR7. Okay, please hold on. Let me see if I can. Okay, good. Okay. Now look at this code. This is a plain, simple PHP procedural code, something that I probably wrote about 20 years ago. So let's say if I were to have a web form to get some requests from a user and to return a response, this would be how I do it. Now, using a framework, for example, Zen framework, this will be how it will look like. And there'll be some methods, some classes to extend, and some way to actually return the response. There are many, many ways of doing this. The code cannot be reused. Different frameworks, different ways of doing things. Every framework comes up with their own abstraction of HTTP request and response. Now, PHP is basically a web programming language. It's used to make websites. So we are dealing with HTTP request and response. And so there are always new things to learn, cannot switch easily. If you learn Zen framework, you go to another company, they are using Symfony. You have to learn all the way from the start. So now, can you see a similarity between these two pieces of code? Receive a request, process it, and return a response. So what do frameworks abstract from PHP? Form post, accessing of the server, super global variables, extract the request URI for routing, handle file uploads, input output streams, and returning a response. And every single framework, they come up with proprietary classes and ways to handle this, and they cannot be reused easily outside the framework. So now this is a web application in the simplest form. A client sends a request to a server, and the server returns a response. This is a HTTP model, red for request, green for response. And if you see, for request and response, you see there's a verb, let's say get. And there's a URL, say slash, what is the resource that you're trying to access, and the protocol. For the response, you get back the protocol, status code like 401, 500, and the reason phrase. Okay, sorry if it's a bit too technical. Actually, this was part of my PSR workshop at the PHP conference. That was in September. So that was a 2.5 hours workshop. So this is part of it. Okay, every HTTP request message has a specific form. And similarly for HTTP response messages, you have some liners, some headers, and you have a body. In short, this is a big overview of PSR 7. It recommends some interfaces for PSR projects to actually adopt. Now, interface, as we all know, basically the implementation details is up to you. But you just make sure that you have this method so that, well, if this class says that it implements this interface, you can be sure that you will have this method signature and you will have this return value. So every box here is an interface. For example, you see the request and response interface, they extend from the message. And server request makes use of the uploaded file and stream. One thing to note is all this. One key concept is immutable value objects. Okay, I will explain a bit more about this later. First, we look at message interface. Our request and response, at its simplest form, is basically a message. And we know at the last line, message with header and with body. This will return a new instance, a new object. Objects are passed by reference in PHP. So if you don't return a new object, right, there is a possibility that you might accidentally modify it later on by reference. So all the with methods will actually return a new instance. Request interface to model a request from the client. So you can get a URI, you can write to the body, and you can create a new request for a certain URI and with a header and with a body. Response, a response to return to the client. So there's a status code, reason phrase, and you can add a new body. And the last line, if you were to set a status code 200, you'll get a new response instance altogether. Server request interface. Basically, it's to abstract out all the server super global variables and make it easily accessible. So you don't need to remember, in order to get the remote address of the request, I will call $_server_remote_address. I will just call request get server params. That's it. Regardless of framework. So if this framework adopts this PSR 7, you just need to remember one set of methods for all these frameworks. Stream interface. For the body writing of a request and a body, it's not, because sometimes the body is passing streams where you might read it partially to, let's say, for bandwidth or for performance purposes. So they decided to model the body of request of response as a stream rather than just a normal native stream. Now, has anyone worked with the files superglobal before? $_files. Now I just ask you whether this is correct. Supposing if I were to upload two files in a web form and I access $_files, would this, is this correct? Long time, huh? Yeah, long time. Wow, it was a struggle. Okay, actually, now this is what we will expect. This is what we expect to see for two uploaded files, but the reality is no. Reality is this one. So they actually have an array of properties, and each property will actually have the array of the actual file uploaded. So you find that it's kind of, I have no idea, I'm not sure about the history for this use case. So for PSR7, they have an uploaded file interface. So all you need to do is, from the request that's coming from the web form, there's a method called getUploadedFiles. So each of them have implement the uploaded file interface, and you can just use these methods like get client file name, get client media type, get size to get the information from each file. Then will be URI. What's in your URI? We have the scheme, the user information, host, port, query, fragment. Sounds easy, right? You try to compose a URI using the server super global in PHP. Okay, there are many different combinations. Let's say you just, okay, never mind, just get the scheme and then plus the host and then plus the query, that's it. But you forget the port. Okay, and you forget there may be HTTPS. And you may forget that actually there is some other things which I can't remember right now. So every framework likely has its own way to compose the URI, and they will have different class names. Zen framework probably will call it Server Global Symfony, probably by another name. So this is where the URI interface comes in. You will get a URI from the request, and from the URI you can get the scheme, user information, host, port, path, query, fragment, and if you want to modify the URI, okay, just use the with URI to return a new instance, a new object. Okay, does anyone have information overload? Okay, this slide was from the workshop as well. So, this is Chiyan's favorite emoji. Yeah. So what is so exciting about this? Why did Matthew Weofini call this the future of PHP? It's like, you know, just a bunch of interfaces, right? And if nobody implements it, then yeah. So even if all the frameworks were to implement it, what is the goal of it? It's just that we reduce something to memorize, right? Okay. So PSR 7 by itself is not exciting. It's very technical, like probably information overload. But the exciting part is that it gives way to the next thing, middleware. Now, what is middleware? A middleware basically is like black box. It takes in a request, processes it, and returns a response. Now, there are many ways of using middleware. One way is the what we call the onion style, like onion. You have layers and layers. So I'm going to give an example of, let's say, fast food, McDonald's. Let's say we have a burger. Okay. The request. Let's say Michael is a customer. He orders a chicken burger. Okay. Then the first middleware, the first layer on the outermost layer. Okay. Let's say Vina. She is the cashier. She collects the money. She passes the request and the empty response to the next person. Let's say Okay, Jonathan. Okay. And Jonathan is the second middleware, the second layer. He's an expediter. He modifies the response with the wrapper paper and the bottom bun. You know the bread, right? The bun. and then you pass the request and the response to the next person. Okay, Britta. Okay, Britta will now modify the response with cheese and lettuce, and then pass the request and response to the meat guy, the next person. And finally, wait, do I see another person that I can remember the name? Okay, Chian. Okay, finally, the meat guy, Chian, the last middleware, he modifies the response with the meat patty, the chicken patty, and he passes the response back to the previous person, the last, which is Britta, who passes it back to Jonathan. Okay, and Jonathan, he will add the top bun to the response, and wraps it, and passes it back to Vina, who is the first layer of middleware. And Vina will pass the response, which is the burger, to Michael. So now, if for example, let's say when it comes to Jonathan, the second middleware, he runs out of buns. He will not even bother passing anything to the rest of the middleware. He will just tell Vina, the first middleware, hey, no bun, tell customer, go home. Now, in code, we are all developers. Okay, so let's look at code. So this will be how it looks like. It's a function that takes in a request, a response, which may be empty, and a callable. A callable basically is the next middleware to call. So can you see something similar, something important about this? Server request interface, response interface. These are the ones that's defined by PSR7. And we can have a middleware pipeline, not unlike, let's say, a manager. So you tell the first middleware, okay, this is the request and response, and this is the, you will call this second middleware later. And then he will marshal it. Now, before we have framework specific methods, parent classes, naming convention. So this is an example from Zen framework. You need to extend an abstract action controller. Supposing, let's say, you need to go to the index page. So to get a request, you call get request. Probably another framework may say compute request. Or another request will probably say get me my request. So in order to get the information from the web form post, you use get post. And how about the rendering? The rendering is using a view model which is tied to the framework. Okay, and it's passing over an array. Now with middleware after. Notice there is a plain PHP, plain old PHP class. And it has the same signature for all middleware. Basically it's an invoke function. Okay, which is in the server request interface, response interface, and the callable. At the end of it, you return a response interface. Now, yeah, you must be telling me, but Zion, this is much longer than the code just now. How is it better? Now, this is not tied to any framework. For any frameworks that are providing PSR7 wrappers like Zen, Symfony, and Slimrite, I can just reuse this class and bring over. So let's look at the first line. User text equals to request get pass body. This is a PSR7 interface method. So you'll work across all frameworks that implement PSR7. Response get body right. This is also a PSR7 method. Then we see something which seems to bring a problem. This render app text, user text. So there seems to be a problem here, right? This is not PSR7, but this is okay. But this, because it's injected via the constructor as a dependency, I may use tweak, I may use plates, or I may use Zen view. So I'm not tied to a particular implementation or library or the framework. It depends on what I inject in. And finally, I return it. How do I return? I can either return a response or I pass a request and response to the next middleware. Now imagine, no more framework silos, just middleware. Symfony framework have Symfony bundles. Zen framework has Zen modules. Laravel framework has Laravel packages. That means all these people, they're solving the same problems over and over and over again, but wrapping them up as a framework specific solution. So we need to stop that. We are PHP community, we are not a Zen framework community, we are not a Symfony framework community, we are PHP developers. Now, coming back to this diagram, Supposing I'm writing a REST API and I have 1,000 endpoints. So for illustration, let's think that probably we write one class for each endpoint. So you have 1,000 classes. Suddenly your manager tells you, we need to add authentication, OAuth 2 authentication. What do we do? Do we go to the 1,000 classes and then we add the same line, say, before, at the first line, right, we also check, is authenticated, continue, else, exit. But with middleware, we don't need to. We just add a authentication middleware in front of the router middleware. So we just add it in the outer layer. Now, another implementation that will be useful for this onion-style middleware is logging. Supposing I have a logging middleware at the outermost layer. When the request first comes in, unmodified, pure, the original client request, the logging middleware can log it, or probably upload to the database or put in the log file. And then when the response is going to go out, it's going to go through the log middleware again, so it can capture the final response just before it is returned to the client. So for debugging purposes, this is quite useful. Now, if your interest is big and you want to find out more, there's this micro framework called Xen Expressive. It is part of the Xen framework tree family. Xen, as Michael mentioned, right, is the one who does the Xen engine that powers PHP. So I'm going to show you the website. Okay. So PSR7 middleware in minutes. It build and consume PSR7, create middleware applications. You can use routing library of your choice. You are not tied to Xen framework. Doesn't mean that this is by Xen technologies, you need to use their components. No, you can use others. Dependency injection. Only inject what you need via the constructor. Templating, you can use a variety of templated engines. You're not tied to XenView, you're not tied to Twig, you're not tied to Pix. You can use anyone that you like. And of course, error handling. So Xen, Slim, Symfony frameworks are already providing PSR7 wrappers. That means if you were to write the plain old PHP class just now that has a simple magic invoke method, that is in the PSR7 request, PSR7 response, and the callable, you'll be able to use it in all these frameworks without rewriting your code. And that's it. Thank you very much. Any questions? Someone actually asked me during the PSR workshop, so if this PSR 7 is so powerful, right, so why are the frameworks supporting it? Won't they run out of business? But the thing is, the purpose of all these frameworks and our community is open source and to share, not we are not proprietary. Okay? So the thing is, they want to do the best for the community. If you keep everything to yourself, right, yeah, then you end up like someone. So the purpose of our community over here, especially in our PHP user group, right, is to share. So another call for speakers. If you have anything interesting to share, please contact Michael. Okay.